morning. This is Michael Davis with your morning announcements.
What were you most afraid of in coming to Brady?
I was most afraid of, just everything, because I was new to the district and I didn't, know anything about anything. So it really did help with my friends. They helped a lot with welcoming me and making sure, that I was, okay with, my friends, or making new friends and, getting around.
I was most afraid of getting my locker jammed, and I was afraid that I would be late to class and I'd get so many detentions, but I didn't get one.
Probably most afraid of the 3-minute break in between periods. I was afraid that I wasn't going to be able to get my books in time and be late to all my classes.
I think personally the thing I was afraid of most was probably all the older kids around me, because when I was at Moreland my last year, I was the oldest one there, and I kind of knew a lot of the smaller kids, but when I went up to Brady, I didn't really know anybody because I wasn't used to the school, so it was hard to find my way around and to know some people who weren't in my grade.
So the thing I was most afraid of was making new friends, and even though I have been going here ever since preschool, I found out that none of my friends were going to be on my team. They were all going to be on Team B, and I was going to be on Team A. So I was really nervous at trying to find new friends, but it actually turned out really well because there were other kids on my team who had the same thing happen to them. So me and those kids kind of bonded, and some of them are my friends.
How long did it take before you were feeling comfortable?
It didn't take very long because I knew most of the people who were going to Brady with me, and we did a lot of getting used to our schedule and stuff with our web leaders, and that really helped with getting used to everything and where everything was in school.
Probably about a week before I got all organized with my stuff, I could open my locker, I got used to going from class to class and all that. It was just getting ready for the year.
About probably the first week, maybe week and a half, because I just got used to the schedule. I still had to look at the little sheet, but I got used to everything, used to the pretzel machine. And
really not that long. It's in the first couple days that you'll start to feel comfortable. And the first couple days are basically orientation. So yeah, you'll feel comfortable then.
It took me about 2 weeks because you have to get used to the a little bit of more homework, and you have to get used to stopping at your locker every time and having to unlock it instead of just going to your book bag and opening your book bag up. So it took some time, 2 weeks to get used to.
What do you remember about the first week?
Mrs. Wagner called me down to be in the balloon race. So we had two chairs, and we put a balloon on each one. So you had two teams, and you had to run across the gym and sit on the balloon until it'll pop. And you have to do it as quick as possible, and my team won because of me. So that rocked.
I remember the first day, I remember I was nervous, but going through, I remember being excited to come to Brady and have all the freedom to just walk around and not be in a line like I was in elementary. So that was pretty good.
That's the bell.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down unfamiliar road, and although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Nice ride.
you to learn how to hustle or how to make it through. You start to see and realize the truth. You start to realize who your true friends are, who's been helping you in the dark, someone that's been with you from the very start.
Tips.
Well, if you want to stop being late to some of your classes, what you could do is maybe get a schedule planned out in your mind to when to go to your locker, what books you need to go to each class so you don't forget things or you're on time for class.
If you're a new kid, you can try to go to different people and introduce yourself and try to make new friends. Like you were a new kid, Destiny, you tried to make new friends and you found
some. Not allowed to show your shoulders.
No. It has to be over your shoulders.
Like this.
No, this, but this.
Yeah. So cover your shoulders.
Exactly.
Or wear sweater. No belly shirts or anything?
Oh, no, definitely no.
Because you're not a belly dancer, you're a middle schooler.
Yes. We've flat nipple very nicely.
Yeah.
Yes.
There's some other things. Oh, no saggy pants because...
Oh, for the guys, yeah.
Yet again, you're not a rapper, you're a middle schooler. And...
What else?
Use your common sense.
Yeah.
Pajama pants?
Oh, yes. No pajama pants. Only on spirit days. Like, these rules should all be blown away on spirit days. But any other day, no. Illegal. Oh, and if you do break the dress code, you do have to get...
You get consequences. You either... Mrs. Wagner either takes you into your office and calls your mom and is like, you know, Micaiah is wearing an inappropriate shirt today.
And
so,
then they bring your clothes or take you home. No, they don't take you home.
They'll send you home if you're like really dressed like really inappropriately. And so another consequence is, you know, they just say, you know, can you change? And sometimes they'll let you change into your gym uniform.
Oh, yeah,
that kind of sucks, but
yeah.
That's what you get for wearing bad choice clothes.
Yes.
And or she'll just, you know, call your mom and say, you know, hi, Mrs. Micaiah, can you bring up a different shirt?
So
that's the dress code.
Just dress wisely.
Yeah.
My final tip would be to keep your locker organized. I know it seems like, why does it matter? But it matters because it's really easy to find books, and if you just throw random papers in there, then you wouldn't be able to find it later. And like, say you throw a homework in there and you can't find it, then you get like a zero, then you have to redo it. So it's very useful to have your locker clean.
If you're getting bullied, you should fill out an incident report in the office so you can, like, prevent other people being bullied and so you can stop you being bullied. And also, you should really know the difference between bullying. If they're, like, constantly doing it, then that's bullying. But if they do it one time and leave you alone, it's not bullying. That's just them being mean.
So this is my locker. And
I am going to show you how you're going to open your locker when you get here. So you want to turn it to the right a few times so you can reset the lock, and then stop on your first number. I actually stopped right on it.
Just 13, guys.
Pass it up once, and then go to the second number. And then just 46. Twist it right to the third number.
45.
And then open. Brian, get your hand off the locker. And then it opens.
Wow. There we go. And that's the inside of a locker?
Totally not neat at all.
It's neat and Brian's. It's pretty. Like, there's not that much stuff in it.
Yep.
Pretty neat. Got the shelf.
It's pretty
neat. Gotta keep your backpack in there.
No, you don't.
Textbooks okay. On the bottom. There it is.
You don't have to keep your backpack in there, by the way? Yeah.
Put it in your
classroom.
My teacher made it.
Classroom.
Just let you all
know that.
Tips. Here's some tips. Tips to open your locker. Do it fast. You only have 3 minutes to the bell, so you're going to need to do it pretty fast.
Yeah. All right. Oh, so, you know, like, first day you come here, you get your stuff and everything, you get a locker, so you could, like, practice.
Do you have any tips on remembering your code, your locker code?
Write it down in your planner.
Yeah. They have it in your schedule.
In your agenda. Oh, yeah. They have it already printed in your schedule, so it should be printed. Keep up with your planner.
What's the best thing about Brady?
The education.
All right. Nice answer.
The freedom.
All right.
Freedom is the best.
Brady.
Well, Brady's an amazing place, and you're just really independent, and the food's a lot better than Moreland, and it's just really an amazing experience all around. Yeah, I love Brady. Woo.
The best thing about Brady?
The freedom. Independence. Yeah.
Remember to keep pulling.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Ray Ray! All
right, what's the best thing about Brady?
Ray Ray!
Woo!
Teachers!
Stringing us along. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Those are the announcements for today. Thank you and have a great day.